You learned in school that your heart is on the left side of your chest, your liver is on the right, and your stomach on the left next to it. Everything in your body has its place. But what if it was all flipped? What if your heart was on your right, your liver on the left? It would look pretty different, but would it work the same? Well, it turns out it would. While it's rare, there are people who have this condition. It's called situs inversus, where the inner organization is a mirror image of what we'd consider normal. This property of the human body is called chirality. It's a form of asymmetry in which the mirror image of something isn't the same as the original. And beyond the setup of our organs, it's found in pairs of gloves, our cells, even the building blocks of proteins. To illustrate this point, a pencil would be achiral, because if you flip it, you can still overlap it. But a glove, for example, if you flip it, you can't overlap it. So symmetry is pretty common in nature. We see radial symmetry in flowers and jellyfish, bilateral symmetry in lots of animals, including humans, and spherical symmetry down to the scale of atoms and their electron orbitals. But like our example of internal anatomy, asymmetry, also called chirality, is equally prevalent, particularly in the case of macromolecules, like proteins. So quick recap, what are proteins? When we think of proteins, we usually think of the food group. So like meat, beans, those workout milkshake powders. The protein we eat is made up of chains of small molecules called amino acids. Human proteins are made up of combinations of 20 different amino acids. These amino acids are linked together in a chain, which then folds into a unique specialized structure that allows the protein to do its job. So what does this have to do with symmetry? Well, almost all amino acids are chiral. So if you took the mirror image of one of these molecules, it wouldn't match the original molecule. They have a so-called handedness, in contrast to a molecule like, say, methane, which would match its mirror image, achiral. So when a molecule is chiral, we call the two different forms enantiomers. So like the inside of the human body, amino acids are chiral and favor a specific direction. The vast majority of naturally occurring amino acids are L amino acids. They have the so-called left-handed orientation. Unlike our organs, right-handed amino acids don't work as expected. All of our proteins are made of L amino acids, and it's not totally clear why. We do know that we can engineer right-handed proteins that work under some specific circumstances, but in general, proteins made of right-handed or combinations of right and left-handed amino acids won't properly fold or function. Amino acids aren't the only building blocks that have a preferred handedness. Nucleic acids, which make up DNA and RNA, do as well. Interestingly though, these molecules have the opposite handedness of amino acids. They're mostly in the D form. So where do the L and D prefixes come from? L stands for levorotatory, which means left rotating, and D stands for dextrorotatory, which means right rotating. This comes from an interesting consequence of these molecules' asymmetry. They can rotate light. Light as an electromagnetic wave does have a type of directionality associated with it. It's called polarization. Chiral molecules can change the polarization of light in either direction. So this left and right-handed naming actually refers to how the enantiomer rotates the light rather than the shape of the molecule itself. Chiral molecules have a lot of interesting properties beyond just rotating light. Two of the same chiral molecules, differing only in their orientation, can smell or taste totally different. Take the amino acids from before. A lot of them taste bitter in their more common L form, but do a total 180 and they taste sweet in their D form. Likewise, there are lots of chiral molecules with signature scents that have totally different smells in their opposite orientation. Your fresh smelling cleaning spray probably contains limonene, which gives it that nice lemon scent, but only in its D form. If you flip it, the L form of limonene smells more like pine trees. These functional differences extend beyond just exciting our olfactory receptors. Enantiomers of drug molecules can have massive differences in efficacy. Did you know that D ibuprofen is 100 times more effective than L ibuprofen? So while the medicine you take probably has an equal combination of L and D enantiomers in it, only the right-handed one is really doing the heavy lifting. When it comes to symmetry, or the lack thereof, we can see it everywhere. From the scale of the whole organism down to the subatomic particle. Little examples of imbalance are all around us, and they play a fundamental role in how the world works and like how we work. If you want an easy example of how symmetry and asymmetry is intertwined, just look in the mirror.